Hi, I'm James. I do zoology and I'm a third year. So I live nearby Liverpool in a place called West Kirby. It's a really nice little town by the seaside. And I went to an old boys' school for 5 years, a grammar school called Coldy. It was very nice. I was very fortunate to be able to go there. A lot of, I don't know, lads, and it was a very odd environment for me, and so in my sixth form I moved away to a different grammar school, and now this was mostly women and a complete contrast to my previous years for GCSE, and that was very different to now how I see university. But it was an interesting place for me. I was all about my sports back home. I competed internationally for hockey, so at school, my education wasn't sort of my thing. I was all about doing sports and going out every day and getting fit. But compared to university, the lessons, was too vague and really not what I was interested in. But going to university has been a complete change because I can focus on the things I really want to focus on, and the relationship between the student and the lecturer is completely different. They're my friends, I'm treated as an adult, and it's a much more enjoyable experience. Well, I'm a zoologist, so obviously animals are my passion, as you might be able to guess, but in particular conservation. I think a lot of people generally have one thing that, one injustice that they're very sort of passionate about and feel should be changed, and for me, that's animals. You see documentaries, you read books, and you know that there's a problem out there that needs sorting. And it's convenient that my passion is also something I really enjoy. I get to learn about these processes, conservation, how I can help, what roles I can perform to go out and solve this problem, all while, having an amazing time, because it's really interesting, it's really fun, and I'm full of fun facts, so that's great for conversation. So the cassowary in Australia, the rainforest, their eggs are bright green, and it's the men that actually looks after the children. All of my family went to university. I knew growing up that that was the next stage for me. It wasn't so much of a decision I want to go to university. It was kind of assumed that I would, which in a way was quite useful because, it's helping me be successful, and it wasn't a decision that I had to go, do I want to go, do I not? And it has been the right decision for me. I've fitted in really well, and it's an area where I can grow and improve myself. Why Nottingham? Well, I must admit I was a bit lazy looking at universities. I went to Liverpool, which was my closest, and I looked around there, and it was okay. It was a city campus. I knew it wasn't for me. I then l looked online. I made a small spreadsheet, and I went through some universities, and I saw Nottingham's campus, and was like, "That looks really green and wonderful. I'll try go there." And it seemed quite good for zoology. And I was quite lucky, I was right. Yes. So I didn't actually visit Nottingham before I came here. But you see photos and videos exploring the grounds and accommodation, and it seemed to work for me. So I was happy to take a shot. I don't know. When I went to visit my siblings in university, you get a very small glimpse into what university life really is. So you go and you might meet their housemates, and you might go out for a drink at a bar or something like that. And that is just a very, just part of what university life is. And so I knew there were lectures. I knew that, I don't know, you were treated nicer by the people that taught you. I didn't really understand what going into a lecture would be like. I didn't understand what living in accommodation would be like. And so I knew that I didn't really know this, so it was hard to have any sort of ideas before coming in. I just hoped that I would like it. And while being at university, you know, it's happened that the way it's run and the way you live, it works for me. You know, I appreciate having, you know, friends that I live with. I appreciate the societies and the friends and skills that I make there. You know, I appreciate the course and how fun it is. You know, there's loads of different parts of university that you just don't know anything about before you get to university. But now I'm here, I was able to explore all of those and, you know, enjoy them as best as I could. Well, everybody, you know, you grow up with your family and they're the only people you've lived with before. You know, then you go to accommodation, you have your own room and you see other people's room. Okay, they may live a bit different. But then when you move into a house with them, you truly appreciate how different people can actually live. And so, you know, you definitely figure out who you live with better compared to others who you might, you know, you might have disagreements on how tidy you want your house or, you know, how often, you know, you should go out and come in late and how loud you can be, how long. And people often have a strong opinions on, you know, what these rules should be. And, you know, I just didn't realise that was going to be such a thing I needed to be aware of. I remember I had been there about a day. You know, you're trying your best to say hi to as many people as possible, you know, trying to be extra friendly. And down my corridor, there's one room at the very end and then lots of rooms going down. And I was on one of the side rooms and I was walking to my room and the door of the person at the end is open. And there's two women there and they call over to me like, help, help, something's wrong. I'm like, oh no, what is it? You know, hoping that I can do something. And there's a spider and these people are petrified. You know, I'm a zoologist and this was a tiny spider. You know, I was going to be fine. they had lost it and they were absolutely petrified. And I distinctly remember, yeah, my two friends, Freya and G. And, you know, just from that encounter, they were scared of a spider, needed some help. And through that, I have lived with them now for 2 years. So, yeah, it was very convenient that, you know, in the first week I was able to help someone out and, you know, have made really good friends. We had a lab. It was two-part. It's one of my favourite labs that I've ever done. I come in the morning and there's a squid and we've got to dissect this squid. We've got to draw all the parts and there's a process where you get sort of this quill and the ink made by the squid and you've got to sign your name and it's what everybody does. And it was a really cool experience, you know, using ink from an actual squid to sign your name. What they don't tell you is that it actually stinks. And so if you take it home, it then stinks your room out of squid for, you know, about a week or two and it's awful. But the second part of that lecture was a lot less smelly. We had to go in, look at all the different trees of life. I say all, a lot of them. And they had brought in various things like great millipedes and they had brought in these giant yellow moths with large tails, UV scorpions, you know, you shine UV light on them, they were great, glow bright blue. Really, really interesting. And, you know, it was one of the first time that I had met maybe some PhD students and some other lecturers and, you know, you get to talk to people about, you know, some of the animals, you know, the tarantulas and you find out that some of these PhD students have been hiding animals in their rooms. So they would take these little sort of cages and they might keep, you know, like little bugs and stuff in their room and have to hide them when the cleaners come round. So 2 weeks later, I was hiding a millipede in my accommodation, but don't tell anybody that. Oh, yeah, so memorable experience of living in halls. Well, in my hall, I'm not sure about others, they would do events and a sort of a ball. And it was a lovely way to see all of your friends. They would dress up in black tie suits and dresses, you know, all hair up and everything. And it was really lovely. Got given some wine. Everyone sat round, some really nice food. And we all have a bit of a party. You know, it was good fun just sort of saying goodbye to everyone, you know, a nice event to just really say, you know, this year's been great and, you know, this is moving on to second year. Okay, that's a bit of a difficult one, just because, I spent 3 years there. I've got, loads of places and things that I enjoy about campus. I definitely appreciate the lake. It's grand. You can see the Trent building right behind it. It's a beautiful place for a walk, and I love that. I am also very attached to the sports centre. I've been there weekly at least for the past 3 years of my life. It's a place where I've put in lots of hard work. It's a place where I've spent a lot of time with my friends, and it's just a building, but it's also a place where that means a lot to me. Yeah. Okay, so plants and animals, that's my thing. There's a tiny little farm just on the other side of the city centre, and you can go in for free, and or you can make a donation. They're very friendly. And you can go around, they've got, cows and goats, and they had lots of like baby goats and lambs and giant pigs and all sorts. So I used to work in an animal sanctuary, and it just takes me right back to working there. And they were so friendly, and I was speaking to one of the volunteers, and they were like, "Oh yeah, you can come in and you can pet the animals and that kind of thing." A really wonderful experience. And there's also, this is something slightly different. I like houseplants, and there's a place called the Watered Garden on the other side of town as well. And you go in, and the walls are just filled with all these exotic plants. And I would never actually be able to look after as many plants as I buy, but it's a lovely place to go in, and yeah, it's very fascinating. Living away from university compared to home is, for me, a massive upgrade. You've gone from living under somebody else's house with their rules to living in your own place with your rules. When you have dinner, when you get up in the morning, it's up to you. And you could see that as a lot of responsibility, or you could see that as an opportunity to do exactly what you want to do. And that's exactly the way I saw it. It's a lot more freedom. It's living with your friends. It's, doing whatever you want to decorate the house. It's good fun. You can cook together. You can do all sorts. Have your friends over whenever you want. So much better than living at home. Yes, but I obviously appreciate going home to visit my family. But I definitely prefer living at university. Every university will vary slightly, whether that's accommodation or that's, facilities. What has made Nottingham for me is the people. My lecturers, I really get on with. They're wonderful, smart, funny people. I really appreciate the ones that I have. I really enjoy my tutor. He's so supportive, and he really makes sure that I'm doing well, and other students as well. So, I'm part of societies like judo and ballroom dance. The people there, they're so wonderful, not just in the sense that, I may get to dance with them, or, I might fight in judo. It's also, they're my friends through that as well. It's such a welcoming, group of people. And they've really made my time at Nottingham. I could do judo anywhere else, but I wouldn't have had those relationships that I do with these people. Best thing about my course is that it's a force for good. I do zoology. I'm learning about conservation and ecology. The skills and knowledge I'm going to come out of university with can make a real difference to the world. I can go out, and I can genuinely help a conservation issue. I can potentially genuinely stop an animal from being endangered. And I'm kind of in awe that I'm going to get to know, all this information. Not many people can say they've had so much of a difference on the world. And not only that, I'm going to come out with these skills. and I'm going to be able to do good, but through doing this, I'm going to have some of the best experiences. And I'm so fortunate to be able to say that, you know, that's what I do. Support comes in many different forms at university. One example is I'm quite dyslexic, and so, you know, my recall, I'm a bit slower, you know, I need more time to do such and such. Through disabled student allowance, I've gotten, you know, a laptop, a printer, lots of software for me to be able to record lectures, to dictate what I'm saying and turn that into words on the screen. There's been a lot of help in terms of extra time. If there's a deadline and I can't do it, I've got to speak to one of my lecturers, and I can push a deadline back to the time I need that works for me and my dyslexia. But on the other hand, you know, support can come through mental health. I've had some mental health issues, and I have received support for that. You know, my tutor was very understanding, and we've had discussions about it. You know, my friends that I've met through university are very understanding, and I've had, you know, help for that as well. And, you know, the outcome is that I know I'm not there by myself struggling with things. You know, I've got people I can rely on and that I know, and it's so much easier knowing that these people will be able to support me when things are wrong, and, you know, it makes getting better that much easier. Well, I'm actually quite a lazy person, generally, and I like to sit about all day and not do a lot. But I know, obviously, that that's not ideal, and that I have to do things to be able to get where I want. And sometimes I'm not entirely sure of what I have to do. You know, there's so many different things you can do to help you in some way or another. There are so many opportunities. Which do you pick? Which is going to be helpful? You know, it's hard to know all that. But actually, I know it's a bit cringy, but my friends, you know, I have some friends who are extremely intelligent, or they're extremely productive. And you just pick up little bits from everybody. You know, that person has this way of doing their work. Okay, so I can listen to them and I can, you know, use that for myself. You know, this person has this way of writing an essay. Well, I can try and, you know, nick some ideas off him in that sense. You know, my friends, and speaking to them, what have they done for their CV, you know, through, you know, taking these things from your friends. Overall, that forms what I do. And a lot of what I've done has come from other people. I am a big fan of societies. You know, it's where you meet a lot of friends. It's where you meet a lot of opportunities, skills. They're wonderful. And opportunities-wise, you know, it's endless. I'm actually sports secretary for the BioSoc. And the biology society is, you know, it's huge. You know, it's got loads of people from genetics, zoology, biology, and anyone else who wants to join. And as sports secretary, I run 4 sports teams. So we do hockey, volleyball, netball, and football. And I make sure that we have enough players, that the games go ahead on time. And, you know, it's a responsibility, but it's one that comes with benefits. You know, with the society night out, I get free drinks here and there. You know, I also get to lead these teams, and I gain genuine skills. You know, I'm running sports teams, and there's a lot that I can take from that. And also, you know, there's the social side. You know, I go out with these friends. I play a hockey game with these people. You know, I get to know them, and then we can go out for a drink afterwards and, you know, talk about everything else that isn't hockey. Or maybe it is hockey and it's, you know, whether I've missed an open goal or something like that. So, yeah, societies are really fun. Through zoology, you meet a bunch of academics and, you know, people from all over the place. And so, you know, if you get stuck in, you can have interesting conversations with all of these people. You know, they're really friendly and want you to get involved. And you might speak to them about jobs, for example. and they're great at giving advice. And some advice I had was to volunteer at the sort of the nature groups near me. And so during my summers, I volunteered at an animal sanctuary. I got to look after old retired racehorses, you know, pigs, goats, rabbits, you know, all sorts of things. Great fun. I've also done some surveying for rare natterjack toads. And so we would go out at night with these big head torches on, looking like a bit of an idiot. But, you know, I would go around looking at the floor, trying to find as many of, you know, toads and frogs as I could. And we'd record the GPS. And, you know, I'd go around with a bunch of academics, you know, speak to them as well. And through these volunteering opportunities, you know, I got an email from one of the nature groups. And I was asked, do I want to now do some paid surveying? You know, absolutely. Yeah, I love surveying. Do I want to get paid for it? Yes. So, you know, I sent them an email. They asked me to make a CV. I threw one together. Haven't done that in a while. And they gave me a call, had a small interview, and I've got a job lined up for after university. You know, I'm as an ecological consultant. And then it just so happens that I have a lecture a couple of weeks ago about being an ecological consultant. So now I know even more about this job I've got lined up next year. And yeah, it's really exciting. So these volunteer opportunities, you know, where I was pointed towards through university, even though I did some outside, you know, it's helped me get a job. I've had a complicated relationship with field trips because of COVID pandemic. Obviously that's, you know, probably not going to be a problem in the future, but so my very first field trip was cancelled and I was supposed to go to Portugal for 2 weeks and I was going to go out to sort of a wildlife reserve near Lisbon and, you know, do lots of surveying and field work out there. But COVID happened and that didn't happen. Instead, they took us to Sherwood Forest instead and it was really good actually. Yeah, we did some mammal trapping, and so they would show us how they might survey for small mammals and voles and that kind of thing. And we were shown how to use the different traps. And then they took us to a different area near Sherwood Forest, and they put up these mist nets. And birds will fly into these mist nets because they're so fine, they can't actually see them. And so you will then go in carefully, untangle the bird from it, and then you'll take measurements and then you'll get to let it go. And it's really, really exciting actually to be able to, you know, to do all this. And that was a wonderful day. And, you know, we did loads of stuff, whether it was, you know, we're catching fish and, you know, identifying insects and various things. So that was great fun. But I still really wanted to go to Portugal. And so we were supposed to be going to Portugal this Easter instead. But with COVID, we can't go again. And so this time I'm going to the south of Wales on the coast. Not quite Portugal, but it's a field trip away for, you know, 2 weeks. And it's a 20-credit module. It's optional. But, you know, I obviously really wanted to do it. And we had to pick which project we want to work on. And so I've, again, gone for the mist netting of the birds. I'm going to be studying different birds and parasites and comparing data with data taken by previous studies. And, you know, I get to work closely with actual researchers doing this. You know, this is proper scientific research, you know, that's not been done before. I'm then going to be doing presentations and a paper on it. And that's how it's assessed. And so, yeah, it's going to be really exciting. Outside the university, though, there are even more options. And so last summer I was supposed to go to Madagascar and I was going to be going through the rainforest catching reptiles and chameleons. I was going to be taking them back to the camp, this bare bones camp, and I was going to be looking at the colour of the chameleons and how they use that colour to communicate, you know, how physically they are able to change their colour. But COVID happens and I couldn't go to Madagascar. So I was supposed to be taking data for my third year dissertation out there. And I wasn't able to get that data, obviously, because I wasn't able to go. And instead, I'm going to Mexico this summer. And really excited. So I'm going to be going to this rainforest, and it's filled with Mayan temples and, immaculate, rainforest filled with cats and primates and, bats and birds and everything you can think of, amphibians, all sorts. And I'm going to be working as an assistant on, a bunch of different projects. So I'll get to, try out everything. And then I'm going to be scuba diving with turtles. I'll be researching them. I'm going to check how they are affected by tourism, because, it's literally known as Turtle Bay. So there are loads of turtles and loads of tourists. And so we're looking at, how the tourists affect these turtles and just making sure that they're doing okay. I'll be doing some coral reef restoration, and I'll be researching the seagrass that the turtles feed on. And so I'm going to be doing a bunch of research. And the university can actually help me fund that because they have grants, and I'm going to be getting money towards this research. And it will help me with my fundraising to be able to afford it. I've not come to any major conclusion about myself. It's more the small discoveries you make, little bits here and there. Oh, I didn't know I would like that. The little hobbies you take up. I've started knitting. Before university, I would never dream that I would, be knitting. Some of my lectures can get quite long. So in third year, I've had some 3 hour lectures. Now, I'm not very good at concentrating for a long amount of time, and so I would take my knitting into lectures. I can fiddle, with the needles while I'm concentrating, and I can concentrate so much better just by fiddling with this while I watch. And actually, it's been a massive help for me. You speak to people. I went to art society, discovered that even though I'm not very good, painting is really fun. And so, where I've gone from a hobby of pretty much just sports, it's expanded into, loads of different things that I never even dreamed I would even enjoy. And I think, yeah, the discovery is about what I'm into, what I do with my spare time. Yeah, just small things really about yourself that, that pick up and, then become something bigger when you get better at something, or, yeah, so that kind of thing. Apart from the knowledge that I've, learned while being here, I can write so much better. I've had classes on how to construct an essay, how to write properly. And going from secondary school to university, it's amazing at the difference in standard of my work. And in a sense, confidence and communication, because I've got so involved in societies and peer mentoring and subject ambassador, I've had to talk. I've done presentations, and I have to be able to communicate on the spot. Even today, this is me practicing my communication skills, and being able to be confident speaking in a lecture hall, being able to hold a conversation, it's a really important skill. And actually being able to get on with people, it's really useful. And through all of these experiences, you don't notice it, but you're actually, picking up confidence and, communication skills, which are really beneficial, actually. The way you're examined, in my modules, it varies. And at the beginning of university, it was often, especially with COVID, online. It was multiple choice. It wasn't too much writing. It was short answer questions, maybe, and that suited me perfectly. I'm dyslexic, and long writing isn't for me generally. And so that was great. I could do that. And then as we move from first year to third year, more of my modules were coursework instead of examinations. And that proved a bit difficult, especially, when you have an exam, you can revise whatever you want, you can go to your lectures, that's fine, and then turn up on the day and give it your best shot. But with coursework, you often can't just leave it to the last moment because you have 8,000 words to write for a dissertation. The difficulty for me was getting organized enough and writing fast enough to be able to fit it all in, you know, amongst the societies, amongst the social nights, amongst the lectures even. You know, you've got to set this time aside yourself, you've got to do the research, and it's hard to organise. And how did I get over this? Well, apart from picking up ideas from friends, you know, they have lectures online, often about how to structure it and how to fit everything in. But eventually I worked out how I work best, you know, whether that's going to the library or doing a certain method where I work for 25 minutes, break for 5, work for 25, you know, whatever it is, I figured it out how it works for me. And now I'm more easily able to cope with, you know, the long courseworks because I'm able to be more productive because I've matured in the way that I work. It looks like lots of travel. It looks like lots of memorable experiences. It looks happy and bright. I don't want to sound overly optimistic, but my experience at university has been able to set me up and given me something to look forward to. I now know in more detail what I want to go and do after university. And, you know, before university, I picked zoology because I liked animals. I wasn't too sure. And now coming out of university, and I can go, I like this specific bit of ecology and I want to work in that potentially. I like this area of something else that I want to work with. And you've got a mini bucket list of things you want to check off that you didn't even think about before university. And so hopefully my future is going to be those things that, you know, those ideas that I've picked up here. I mean, on the surface, it's an easy question. But looking forward, you know, it's more about looking back, actually. You know, that degree is a culmination of everything I've done for the past 3 years. Getting that degree is climbing the stairs from first year and working hard and getting to the top of that hill and receiving the degree. Now, that's the easy bit. You know, keep climbing after 3 years and, you know, you'll get the end's in sight. You know, you're working hard. I don't want to say relief, but it's going to be, I've done it, I'm at the top of the hill, this is everything I've worked for. Ooh, okay. Might sound a bit nerdy. I would visit all of the national parks in the world. I would just go crazy. I would see all the sights, you know, I would see the ecology. I would go to, yeah, amazing. It would be, sorry. Yeah, I would see everything I've learned about. I would just go and explore, have fun, be in the sunshine and appreciate the natural world around me.